Revision part 2, our session 10. So before we start our today's session, let's have a small recap of what we have done in our last class. So as you can remember, if you recall from our previous class, we had done our session 8, which was introducing oneself. As you remember, there were certain rules which we have to follow while introducing ourselves. So what were they? That first we have to greet other person. Okay? For always we have to greet the other person first. And then we have to tell our name, okay? If we are in a formal setup, we have to say in formal way. Or if we are in with our friends and all, we have to greet in an informal way. Then after having the conversation, okay? After having the conversation, when we finish our conversation, we should close the conversation with a proper closing sentence. Like, pleased to meet you, no? Have a nice day. Or it was pleasure meeting you. So these are the different ways how you end up your conversation. Okay, so this was about your session 8. Now we have our recall from the session 9, that is greeting others. So while greeting someone, we also have to follow certain rules. So these were, when we greet someone in formal setup, we have to use the title. For example, hello Mr. Khan, how do you do? Or good morning Mrs. Laura, how do you do? Okay, so these are the different ways how we greet someone when we are in a formal setup. But when we are in an informal setup, that means with our friend or acquaintances, we just have to say the good afternoon or good morning and then only our first name. For example, hello Tanvir, how are you? Good morning Rekha, how are you doing? So we are only using the first name here. Okay, we are not using the title. So this is how we greet in a formal and an informal setup. Okay, so this was all about our session 8 and session 9. So let us come to our today's learning objectives. That means in today's session, okay, that is in sentence formation, here we are going to learn about the simple present sentence, okay, then where to use do and does and to have got. Okay, so this is how we are going, what we are going to learn today. Okay, so sentence formation 2, session number 10. So please see the sentences, okay, the examples given here. Do, does, simple present, okay. I go to school, I do not run, okay. He likes to watch TV, he does not wash cars. You love movies, you do not sing, okay. Then they make paintings, they do not watch TV. She makes cakes, she does not like candies. Okay, now carefully look at the above figure. That means in the examples, you will notice that in some sentences, verb is followed by s, makes, likes. Yes, while in some other sentences, it is not. Similarly, in some sentences, we use do not, while in some sentences, we use does not. Okay, let us see the affirmative sentences, means the positive sentences. Okay, I, you, yes, he, she, it, we, they, yes. First person, second person and the third person. Here the verb is S and ES. Where it is using, you see, I make cakes, you make cakes, he makes cakes. Yes. Now when the third person, second person comes, that we have to use the S. Yes. Third person, you can see, it makes cakes. Yes. Second person. Now third person, you see, we make cakes, they make cakes. So this is how the the use of the S changes, okay, from singular to plural. Yes, from the first person to the third person. Same way in the negative sentence, you can see I, you, he, she, it, and the third person is we and they. Okay, do, where it is, does is not, does is use where there is the single, the second person. I do not make cakes, you do not make cakes, he does not make cakes, she does not make cakes. Yes, it does not make cakes. We do not make snow. It will be we do not make cakes. They do not make cakes. Okay. Now, see here we have a third person singular rule. Okay. This form, the third person singular rule, means only with the third person singular we will add S or ES, or we will use does or does not. Okay. Then here we have certain examples of interrogative, where questions, where we are interrogating, where we are asking questions. Do, does, do. Okay. Then the first, second and the third. Do I make cakes? Do you make cakes? Yes. Does he make cakes? Does she make cakes? Then again, do we make cakes? Do they make cakes? You can see, okay, these are different interrogative sentences. Okay, then next we have is to have and to have got. That means to show the position. Okay, that means I have a brother, he has a cycle, they have got a house. No, to have and to have got. She has a smartphone. Okay, you have got a ring, we have a TV. Now how to use this? You can see in the examples, no? Affirmative sentences, I, again the first person, he, she, second person, we, they, third person. Yes, so I have a brother, I have got a bike, you have two sisters. Okay, now you can again see, he has got a car, he has a brother and a sister, it has got big wheels. You can see, we have a house, they have got many friends. So to possess, to get, not to have. Okay, so here we are using one, have and have got. Then you see in the negative sentences, okay, where we are, you will use not with have and has. Here you can see, just add not with have and has. For example, I have not got a bike, he has not got free time. Okay, not is used for, because it is a negative sentence. Okay, see, sometimes we may use do not have or does not have as. That means you can see, I, you, we, they, do not have, and he, she, it, we will have use does not have. You can see, I do not have a brother, they do not have friends. Okay, then he does not have a lot of free time. So this is how we use as a negative sentence, have and have not. Okay, so this was all about your session number 10. Let's us do a small recap. Okay, so the summary of today's session 10 is that in some sentences the verb is followed by s, for example makes, likes, and while in some sentences it is not. For example, I make cakes, he make cakes. Okay, these are affirmative, positive. Similarly, in some sentences we use do not, while some sentences we use does not. For example, I do not make cakes, he does not make cakes. Okay, so these are negative, not is used. So same way, do I make cakes, does he make cakes, again these are interrogative, asking questions, do you, does he. Then the third person singular rule, which indicates that only with the third person singular we will add s or es. Okay, or we will use does or does not. Okay, this is the third person singular rule, I think, which you have got already in your English sessions, English classes. So in a sentence, in order to show the position or ownership, we use has or have. Okay, now for example, I have a brother, I have got a bike, we have a house, they have got many friends, all these are affirmative, we have. Okay, just we need to add not to make it negative. Okay, with have and has. For example, I have not got a bike. Okay, then they do not have friends, he does not have a lot of free time. So where not is used, these are negative sentences. So this was all which we have done in session 10. Okay, now let's go to our session 11, that is talking about our family. We all have a family, right? We have our grandparents, our parents, yes, our brothers, sisters, so all these persons together, they form a family. Okay, so now here, learning objectives in this session, it's very easy. We will know about relations and the relationships. Okay, so let's talk about our family. So in our day-to-day life, okay, we need to talk about our family and relations in our family. So family relations in our family, we have our parents, our brothers, sisters, our grandparents. Okay, and in extended family, we have aunts, uncles, okay, cousins. The following table here is showing you the most common relation in family. Okay, here you can see the table there, male, female, and the relationship is shown there. that means male, okay, father, female, mother, relationship is the parent. Then son, daughter, son as female, male, daughter as female, relationship is child. Again, male husband, female wife, relationship is spouse. Then male brother, female sister, sibling, okay, twins means same brother, same sister, okay. So twins, it can be male also, it can be female also, sibling born at the same time, okay, as you. Then grandfather, which comes under male, grandmother, female, they are referred as grandparents. Then grandson, granddaughter, referred as grandchild. Uncle comes under male, aunt, female, parent, sibling, okay. Then nephew, niece, again siblings, child. Then cousin, it can be both male, female, yes. Then it can be aunt or uncle, child. So these are the different relationships which we have in our family, right? So describing the family and the relationships, we can use relations from the above table in order to describe our family. So while telling something about relationships to someone else, we remember that they are the third person, okay. We refer to as them, they, not in the first and the second, not I or you. So you describe them using the third person singular rule, which you have done in sentence formation part 2, that is your session number 10. So here are certain examples how you can refer them. That I have a younger brother, he sings very well. My brother swims too. My husband likes to watch football matches. He is a big Ronaldo fan. His daughter lives in Mumbai. Yes, she is a chef there. My twin has got a beautiful watch. Your uncle is a good swimmer. Our grandparents tell beautiful stories. His wife is a school principal. His cousin is my classmate. Your aunt teaches in our school. Okay, so these are the different examples of how you will refer to your family relations. Okay, so this is all about your talking about your family, that is the relations which you have in your family. Okay, now let us have a small summary of session 11 which we have done. That in our family we have our parents, our brothers, sisters and our grandparents, and in our extended family we will have aunt, uncles, cousins, and most common relations in family are father, mother, which are referred as relationship as parent, son, daughter, which are referred as child. Okay, then while telling something about relationship, okay, to someone else, while we are referring our relationships, we use the third person singular rule. That means, for example, we refer to them as a third person. For example, your uncle is a good swimmer, his cousin is my classmate, our grandparents tell beautiful stories, okay, we refer them as a third person. Okay, so this was what we have done in our today's session, that is session number 11. Okay, so please go through the video, okay, go through both the sessions, go through your textbook, okay, then understand it, okay, and then after that, after this video, I'll be giving you some assignment related to the topics. Please complete it and at the same time keep learning. Thank you and have